Example data which is given as to find the 4-point DFT of x of n and h of n for the given sequences. The given sequences are x of n which is equals to 2001 and h of n equals to 4321. Here it is asked to compute y of k that is equals to x of k into h of k. That means for y of k indicates the DFT of y of n. That is the sequences which is multiplication of x of k and h of k. H of k and x of k are the DFT of x of n and h of n respectively. So here it is asked to you to find x of k, that means DFT for x of n, h of k, that means DFT of h of n, then multiply this to get the final output y of k. So first of all we need to find x of k from x of n. So x of k that will be equals to w4, that means matrix multiplication, as is the matrix method, w4 into x of n. Here this is given as 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 minus j plus j plus j minus 1 minus 1 minus 1 minus 1. Here it is 1. The first sequence over here is x of n, which is 2001. Now let us do the matrix multiplication, which will give 2 plus 0 plus 0 plus 1. Then for the second row, its value is 2 0 0 plus j. The third row value is 2 0 0 minus 1, and the fourth row value is 2 0 0 minus j. So here the answer will be 2 plus 1 3, 2 plus j, 2 minus 1 1, and 2 minus j. This is the DFT of x of n, which is given as x of k. That means here we have obtained x of k that is equals to 3, 2 plus j, 1, 2 minus j. Okay, now the next value is h of n, which is 4321. So to find h of k, again we will use the matrix method to find the DFT of h of n. So as this is 4321, we will do the same procedure for this. That means here h of k that will become multiplication, matrix multiplication using the same matrix, where h of n is 4321, and here we will use the same matrix, minus j, plus j, plus j, minus 1, minus 1, minus 1, minus 1, and here it is 1. Now for this we will have first row value 4 plus 3 plus 2 plus 1, and the next value is 4 minus 3j. Here the next value is minus 3j. Minus 3j minus 2 plus j. Then the next value is 4 minus 3 plus 2 minus 1, and then the next is 4 plus 3j minus 2 minus j. So for this the answer will be 4 plus 3 7, 7 plus 2 9, 9 plus 1 10, and the next value is 4 minus 2 2 minus 2j. Then the next value is 4 minus 3 1, 1 plus 2 3, 3 minus 1 2, and the next value is 2 plus 2j. That means the answer of h of k, that is equals to 10, 2 minus 2j, 2 and 2 plus 2j. Okay. Now, as we have obtained the two values, we will multiply these two values to get the final output. That means here to get y of k, that is equals to x of k into h of k, we will have two values. So y of k equals to, first x of k value is 3, 2 plus j, 1, 2 minus j. Right? 3, 2 plus j, 1. So here, as we have obtained the value of x of k, that is equals to 3, 2 plus j, 1 and 2 minus j. Okay, so this is the value that we have obtained previously. 3, 2 plus j, 1, 2 minus j. Okay. Now, we will write over here the next value that we have obtained, that is x of k. So here h of k equals to 10, 2 minus 2j, 2, 2 plus 2j. So to get the final output y of k, we will multiply the respective elements. So 3 into 10, that will become 30, 2 plus j into 2 minus 2j. So we will multiply 2 plus j into 2 minus 2j. So this value will become 2 into 2, 4. Then 2 into minus 2j, that will become minus 4j. Then plus 2j minus 2j square, that will become j square equals to minus 1. So plus 2. So this value will become 4 plus 2, that means 6. And here minus 4j plus 2j will give minus 2j. Same way, 2 into 1 will become 2, and then the next value is 2 minus j into 2 plus 2j. That means 2 minus j into 2 plus 2j. So here this value will become 6 plus 2j. Okay, so this is the answer of y of k, which is a multiplication of x of k and h of k. Now let us see one more example for IDFT. Till now what we have done, that is we have find out the DFT, that means discrete Fourier transform, using the matrix method. Now we will find out IDFT, that means inverse discrete Fourier transform, from the given DFT sequence. So here as you can see, DFT sequence is given y of k, that is equals to 1 0 1 0. Now we are going to find the inverse discrete Fourier transform for this. So for inverse discrete Fourier transform, we are going to use the formula which is given as y of n, that is equals to 1 by n conjugate matrix for that into y of k. Here 1 by 8, that means n point DFT, which is 4. Then we will use over here the matrix where conjugates are reversed. So 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1. Here instead of minus j, we will take plus j. And here instead of plus j, we will take minus j. Other values will remain same. And here we will multiply this with y of k, which is given as 1, 0, 1, 0. Okay. Let us do the matrix multiplication with 1 by 4 here. So this will give 1 plus 0 plus 1 plus 0. Then the second row value is 1 plus 0 minus 1 plus 0. Then the next is 1 plus 0 plus 1 plus 0. Then 1 plus 0 minus 1 plus 0. So this will give value 1 plus 1, 2. 1 minus 1, 0. 1 plus 1, 2. 1 minus 1, 0. Now we have to divide each values with 1 by 4. That means we are dividing this with 2 by 4, that will give 1 by 2, which is also called as 0.5. Here it is 0. 2 by 4, that means 1 by 2, which is also referred to as 0.5 and 0. So, the inverse discrete Fourier transform for this sequence, that means y of n equals to 0.5, 0, 0.5, 0. Okay, so, this is the answer of IDFT. So, this is how you can find the inverse discrete Fourier transform from its given DFT version. So, I hope that matrix method to find DFT and IDFT is clear to you now. Now, the next example is to calculate the DFT of a sequence which is given as x of n that is equals to 1, 1, 0, 0, and it is asked to check the validity of your answer by calculating its IDFT. Now, in this example, what is to be done? That is, first of all, you need to find the DFT of this sequence x of n using the same matrix method which we have done for the previous examples. Then after finding the x of k, that means DFT of x of n, we need to find the IDFT from the answer x of k. That means whatever the DFT sequence we have obtained, we need to apply the IDFT using the matrix method. That means using the complex conjugate of that matrix. And using that we need to find the IDFT, and it is asked to check the answer. That means whenever IDFT is obtained, it should match with the given x of n. That means the IDFT answer should be 1, 1, 0, 0. So in this example, you need to find first of all x of k, then using IDFT, you need to obtain again back x of n, which must match to the data x of n, that is 1, 1, 0, 0. So these are the various examples that will be asked, and using this matrix method you can obtain both DFT and IDFT. Also you can check for the original sequence given to you back from the IDFT. These are the references. Thank you. Thank you for listening.